friends, welcome back to my channel. My today's recipe is a Maharashtrian dish known as Alu Ka Rasa. This is best served with some puri or kachoris and it makes a hearty breakfast meal. So let's look into the ingredient list now. My first ingredient is of course potato, and here I have around 6 potatoes which I have cut into small pieces and boiled them. 1 onion finely chopped. Around 1 tablespoon of coriander leaves finely chopped. And here I have 1 tomato which I have grinded with a little bit of water and made a puree out of it. 2 dry red chilies, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 1/2 teaspoon of carom seeds or ajwain, and 1/2 teaspoon of dried fenugreek leaves or kasuri methi. A pinch of hing or asafoetida. 1 teaspoon of cumin powder, 1 teaspoon of ginger powder, but if you want you can use ginger paste also, 1/2 teaspoon of dry mango powder, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, and finally this is coriander powder. But what I've done is I've taken whole coriander seeds and dry roasted them and then made a powder of it. So let's start preparing potato curry or Alu Ka Rasa, which it is popularly known as. My pan is on heat and to it I'm going to add in around 3 tablespoons of white oil. Next I'll add in the dry red chilies, cumin seeds and carom seeds. Give it a quick mix. Next I'll add in the chopped onions. If you want, you can use onion paste also instead of chopped onions. But traditionally, it's cooked with chopped onions. And we'll cook this onion till they are nice and brown in color. My onions have been cooking for 3 minutes now, and as you can see, they have started turning brown. At this point, I'm going to add in the dry spices, cumin powder, ginger powder, dry mango powder, turmeric powder, roasted coriander powder and red chili powder, along with some hing or asafoetida. Give the spices a quick mix and we'll add in the tomato puree now. Mix it well again and we'll cook this for another 5 minutes till the oil starts separating. But before that, we'll cover it and cook and reduce the flame to low. It's been around 5 minutes now and I had stirred in between once, and you can see the spices and the vegetable have started releasing the oil. At this point, I'll add in some salt. Salt is of course according to taste. And then I'll add in the boiled potatoes. As you can see, I've added maximum of the potatoes as it is, and few of them I'm going to crush it. I'll use my hands for it. Crush the potatoes and then add them. I'll also add in a cup of water at this point and mix everything well. If you want, you can break some of the potatoes with your spoon also. I'll add in another 1/2 cup of water and I'm going to cover it again and cook it for another 4-5 minutes. My potatoes have been cooking for 5 minutes now. They are almost done. We'll add in the final few ingredients, that is kasuri methi powder or dried fenugreek leaves powder. This actually enhances the flavor of this potato curry a lot. And finally some coriander leaves. Give it a good mix. After mixing the ingredients, I feel the gravy is a bit too thick for me, so I'll add in a little bit of water. The potatoes actually have a tendency of absorbing the water. So I just added another spoon of water and give it a good mix again. And our potato curry is ready to be served. My aloo ka rasa or aloo sabzi is ready, and friends, you all just saw how easy it was to make. Do give it a try, and on that note, I'm going to end this video here. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button. Thank you for watching.